Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jubilan James. For those of you coming across my channel for the first time, please don't forget to hit the notification button and also subscribe and share the video and then like, okay? In this video today, I said I was going to be sharing how you can get a startup loan without collateral, okay? I've been wanting to do this video for a long time now and I've not had the chance, I've not had the opportunity or the chance to actually do this video, but this morning I just decided to do it and share because I know a lot of people are actually waiting for it. Okay, so I will be talking about how you can actually get a startup loan without collateral. Okay, because I know that one of the things that is hindering most people from starting up their own business is finance. So I'm going to be sharing with you one of the avenues, one of the ways you can actually get a startup loan, okay, without collateral, all right? So, but there are a few things you will need to be able to access this loan, all right? So, and one of those things is your BVN and your 6 months bank account, all right? So, this loan is being actually offered by a Sterling Bank through their service called Spectre, all right? So, if you've heard about Spectre.com or MySpectre.com, it's owned by Sterling Bank. And before I continue, please, I want to actually let you know that this is not a paid advert, okay? Or I was not paid to actually do this, okay? Sterling Bank did not pay me to actually do this video or to actually talk about Spectre, their product, okay? I'm actually doing this video because I know a whole lot of people out there are looking for avenues to actually access a loan that they can actually use to start up their business or add to their business and also expand their business. Now, let me also say this, okay? You don't take a loan to test a new business, okay? If you want to test a new business that you are not sure of, you've not done before, please don't take any loan, all right? But if you are sure, if you want to take a loan, let it be that you want to expand an already existing business, okay? Except if the new business you want to actually go into is something you are sure, okay, at least 90% of its return, then fine, you can take a loan and invest into it. But if it's a new venture, you don't know what the outcome might look like, please, I would advise that you stay off it, okay? Now, how does Sterling Bank Spectre Loan works? How do you apply for Sterling Bank Spectre Loan, okay, without collateral? The first step you need to do is to open a current account with Sterling Bank, okay? So if you have a savings account already in Sterling Bank, it will not work. You need to create a current account with Sterling Bank, all right? If there's any Sterling Bank branch close to you or in your city, you could actually walk into any of the branch and actually create a current account first. That's the first step. So you look for any Sterling Bank, even though you can actually create this account online, but for you to be faster, okay, for the verification process to be faster, I would advise you walk into the bank, any Sterling Bank branch close to you, and actually open a current account, all right? So the moment you create a current account with Sterling Bank, then the next step is for you to actually go to Sterling Bank, okay, meet your account officer or your marketer, whoever that created the account for you, and tell them you want to apply for Spectre Loan, my Spectre Loan, okay? Now, the procedure is very simple. You can actually apply online, okay? I know a lot of people who have applied online and they actually got approved, okay, depending on what is that's the volume of deals, transactions in your account statement, okay? You can actually apply online, but to actually get your loan approved faster, then you need to work with the bank, with the branch, okay? Now, if you apply online and your loan is being approved by Sterling Bank, so basically, the branch manager of Sterling Bank where you created the account would need to approve the loan, to ascertain that you are a customer in that branch, okay? So that is why sometimes it's easier for you to actually work with somebody in the branch. So now, what do you do next after you must have created your current account in Sterling Bank? Meet your marketer, meet your account officer, and tell them that you want to apply for Spectra loan, okay? They will ask you for 6 months account statement from your other banks, like assuming you have account in GT Bank, Zenith Bank, Fidelity Bank, and the rest of them. You would need to give them 6 months, okay? They will give you the duration of the 6 months time account statement you give to them, and they also tell you the process of how to submit this account statement to them directly, okay? So you go to your bank app. If you have the app like GT Bank, if you are using GT, you use your GT Word app. With your GT Word app, you can actually generate this electronic account statement and send to them directly from GT Bank. Okay, GT Bank will actually charge you. Okay, your bank will actually charge you for the account statement. All right, you send to them. Now they will go through it. Okay, the system goes through it and see the number of transactions you run in a month, and I don't know how they check it, but I know it has to do with the volume of transaction, not the actual amount of transaction actually, but the volume. That's the how regular, how consistent you've been running the account. Okay, then if the amount you're applying for if the amount you're applying for and what is in your account statement does not correspond, then they will actually tell you how much you are qualified to apply for. Then you can actually apply for that amount. But if your account statement qualifies you for the amount you apply for, they will approve it. Okay, it's actually, if you are doing it online, it's instant approval. Okay, if you are doing it online, it's instant approval. Now, but if you are doing it in the branch, I think it will take some maybe days or so, or it could be instant too if you submit them the account statement electronically. So once they approve the loan, okay, and the branch managers signs and the money is released into your current account, the next thing is the monthly repayment. Now, how much percentage will Sterling Bank charge you? Okay, the interest rate is 27%. So you are the one that will also choose the time duration, whether you want to pay in 6 months, in 4 months, in 2 months, in 3 months, in 1 year. Okay, so let's do some calculation how you repay this loan. Assuming you apply for 1 million naira, okay, and you have to pay back 27% at the end of 12 months, and you want to pay it in 12 months. So you do 27% of 1 million naira, okay, which is 270,000. Am I correct? Yes. 270,000 naira is the 27% of 1 million naira. That means in a year, you're expected to pay 1,270,000. All right, in a year. So that is the capital, the cap principal, which is the 1 million you took, and the interest rate of 27%. Okay. They will add it together, which is 1.270 million naira, okay? 1.2 million 70,000. They will divide it by 12. Whatever figure you get is what you'll be paying every month for the next 12 months. Oh, that's the repayment. And this payment will be deducted automatically from the current account you just opened with Sterling Bank every 28th of the month. Every 28th of the month, which means every 28th morning, every 27th, make sure that the monthly repayment is in that current account you open with Sterling Bank. So 28th early morning, they debit your account and take back their monthly repayment for 12 months. Okay, that is how you repay back this loan. All right, now there's a tip behind applying this loan. If you want to apply this loan, I would recommend that you apply between 16th to 31st or 30th of the month you want to apply it for. If you the terms and condition of this loan is, if you apply for the loan from 1st to 15th of a month, of any particular month, your repayment starts from that same month. So, which means, for example, you applied for the loan on the 5th of this month and it was approved, irrespective of when you assess the cash, okay? Because the bank manager will have, the branch manager will have to approve the loan before it gets to your account, before you can now assess it. So irrespective of when you finally assess this cash, that same 28th of that same month, you'll be charged, your repayment starts. But if you want to start from the previous month, then I would advise you apply from the 16th. So every application that happened from the 16th of the month to the end of the month, your repayment starts from the next month. So right now, today's date is, I think, 18. So if you apply from 16th of this month, which means your repayment will start from 28th of next month. Okay, so that is one or two things you need to understand about this loan. So you don't just go and apply on the 1st, on the 2nd, then on the 28th of that same, probably you actually finally assess the cash maybe on the 16th or 17th of that same, and 28th, they already charge you your monthly repayment and you get worried. Why did they charge you and all that, okay? And like I said, you need your 6 months so account statement from another bank, not banking with that, not the one you just created with Sterling Bank, and your BVN. That is the things you actually need, then a current account with Sterling Bank. So that is how to assess, get a fast loan right now for your startup business. You could actually assess any amount and you could also decide when to pay. So like I said, the first step, walk into any Sterling Bank branch, create a current account. All right, when you are done with that and you have your ATM card from Sterling Bank, you could now apply for Spectre loan. You could talk to your marketer, your account officer, and tell them you want to actually apply for Spectre loan, and then tell them the amount, submit the account statement to them, and once it's approved, you get the money wired into your account, no stress attached, okay? So without any collateral, as long as you attach your account statement, your BVN, and every other detail they need from you, okay, you are good to go. So that is actually how, and I already have a video, I've talked about this before now, so you could actually check up there to watch the video that I talked about this Spectre loan before previously in one of my videos. I've talked about it before. So you go through it and actually watch and also see the steps too, the procedures on how you can apply online. That's if you wish to apply online. But if you apply online, you still need to go back to the branch to get your account verified and all that and all that. Okay, which might take a little time. But if you work with the branch, okay, it might be faster for you. That is how you can assess a quick startup loan right now. Okay, so remember I said this is not a paid advert, this is not a paid post. Okay, I'm just doing this too because I know a whole lot of people out there might need it, maybe to actually expand their business or to do one or two out there. So this is actually how you can get your startup loan. And in case you got value from this video, please hit the notification button and like, subscribe, and also share, okay, this video. Thank you very much.